said it was a game. Well, then I hope for all of our sakes that it is a game.
Well, why is that, sweetheart?
This game's gonna be won.
Welcome back, Game Monsters, to the Complete Guide to Horror podcast. Today, we're asking you a simple question. Would you rather? This movie was released in 2011. I gotta say, pleasantly surprised by how much I enjoyed this movie. In the film, main protagonist Iris is a young woman caring for her sick brother, Raleigh? What the fuck is that name? Stupid name. Who is unable to afford the cost of his treatment for leukemia. I'm just gonna call him Iris's brother from now on. Iris's brother's oncologist, Dr. Barden, introduces Iris to Shepard Lambrick, a philanthropist who heads the Lambrick Foundation that manages schools and hospitals in third world countries. Lambrick offers her a deal. If she wins a parlour game at a dinner party he's hosting, he will pay for her brother's treatment and use his foundation's influence to shortlist a bone marrow donor for him. The parlour games quickly become more violent and dangerous as Iris struggles to win the games and become the ultimate parlour game queen.
What exactly is the game?
Well, it is not a quiz or a trivia contest, nor is it a test of brute strength or athleticism. At its core, it's just a children's game, and I would wager that some of you here this evening have played Would You Rather?
Towards the end, it does get really stupid, and like I can't defend the film at a certain point, but I like the premise, and I do think it's like reflective of its budget, it's reflective of like the inexperience with the screenwriters, but it's like a nice film where I'm like, all right, I don't have regrets watching it. I just have some notes on how to improve it.
It seems like one of those movies that it's not sure how far it should lean into its comedic value. I kept not knowing whether I should watch it as a horror movie or as a comedy. Some of the people in the lineup are generally comedy actors. I mean, you've got the guy from Trailer Park Boys there.
My first order of business is to tell the prosecutor to shut the fuck up and wipe that stupid fucking grin off his face because it's distracting leading my case. Next, I'd like to announce that Randy and Leahy have been drinking all fucking day. They're wasted in their fucking minds, and they're both assholes. And the testimony they just gave was total fucking bullshit. And I can prove it, and I'm going to show you what really fucking happened here.
Got John Hurt, who can kind of go either way, but he's done a lot of comedy roles and stuff. I mean, he was in fucking Home Alone, for fuck's sake. You've got Sasha Gray trying to act, doing her best, but not really pulling it off, doing lots of rolling her eyes and stuff.
My thoughts exactly.
So it was a bit inconsistent, but it was like interesting enough for me to watch and kind of like enjoy, but it was just teetering on the edge of being like a horror comedy. And the bad guy, the businessman dude or whatever, is just a comical character.
Waluigi time.
I thought the son character was cool. The idea of like his son's, you know, even worse than him. But then he fucks up, and then you just, is it implied that kid dies, or like, because you just never see him for the rest of the movie?
I thought either he died or he didn't want any part of it after he was like, not like humiliated, but I could never figure that
out. It was a bit strange. I always thought it was kind of implied that his dad went upstairs and killed him, but they never really answer that. He's just not there for the rest of the movie, which seems a little strange considering how fucking psycho he is. Surely he'd want to be in the room with him. So I just assumed he got killed, but strange little movie, this one. I enjoyed it. I had a good time with it.
I said what I said.
It wasn't bad. What was the budget on it? Do we know?
I did look this up the other day. I know it was quite a micro budget.
It's not on Wiki, so
it must be like 1.2 million or something.
Wouldn't be much.
I mean, I think as a safe guess, it was less than 5 million. I don't think it would have been probably 3 million, taking into account the lack of marketing, some of the stunts that would have been needed.
It wasn't bad as a movie. My comment I wrote was, sounds good on paper, lacks cohesion. These movies, I've seen quite a few of these scenarios where it's obviously like one room. There's a movie I've seen where it's like 50 people in like they're standing and they die one by one or something. I don't know what it's called.
So cool.
It's the same sort of like premise where it's like one room and I think it is. So that sort of thing, like it's just one room, it's just shot in one room, and like it's good for maybe like 20 minutes or 25 minutes or something, but after that, I'm just going to be bored because like how much are you going to change this up? Like this is going to go for an hour and a half. Like you've got to make it somewhat interesting. So I found it kind of got a bit boring because it's just sitting around the dining table and it was just taking its sweet ass time to go through each person and what's happening. Like it's not bad. I wrote a comment on here. So there was the scene where the guy continuously keeps getting lashed, and I never really understood why he kept getting lashed.
Yeah, you might have missed that. He insulted his son, and then the son was like, "Oh, you're going to regret that." And then so they were just picking on him after that.
Yeah, it went on for like 3 or 4 occurrences after that, and I was just like, "Holy shit, this guy's like getting lashed like 3 or 4 times like after." And then the other one that I thought was a bit bullshit was the 4 minutes underwater. Mm-hmm. I didn't really understand that, because I'm like, "There's no, like," he's like, "Well, it's not. It's certainly not impossible." And I'm like, well, no one there is scuba diving. Yeah. No one there is, a Guinness World Record person for going underwater. So I never understood that whole logic. Like, obviously, they're going to die. It was interesting enough. And I probably won't watch it again. But for the sake, it was, not too bad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good. It was good enough for one sitting.
Yeah.
Like BP was saying, like, they're just sitting around the table. They kind of just hit the roof. And then, like, there was nowhere to go from there. There wasn't really anything that they could have done. Unless there was some kind of like big chase or whatever. So it was just like, And oh my God, I called the ending just before it happened when she was going home. I was like, yep, and he's dead. And boom, there it was. And I meant to feel bad. Fuck off.
I don't understand why they spent some time being like, oh, feel bad for her because her brother's sick and he really needs the money to do this and do that. And it's like, but then why fuck that up by having such a shit ending?
Yeah.
I remember me and my partner at the time, we were talking about this one part in the movie that we both were just like, oh, come on, where the doctor decides to have a conscience and is like, no,
out of nowhere, finally. Yeah.
Like, how many times has he recommended other people to this type of party?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And now it's like, oh, what? He got horny for the blonde girl. So that's why he feels bad. I wish they had gone into more with the party host character. Like, when I think about this movie, I think of how much of a bravado and how over the top and just laughable some of his lines were, because he's clearly reveling in this whole, this is my party game. You'll do what I do. Yay!
And like, he has that annoying moustache. Very like a, maybe like a colonel moustache or something. I don't know. It's very annoying.
As the game continues with one dilemma after another, eliminating players as we go until we have a winner.
Like, I wish he was the main character. Instead of it being around Brittany Snow, she was just like part of this party game, but the whole thing was from the host's point of view. It would have been a lot more gripping as a movie, because obviously we're watching this movie because we want to see how these people die. But there were some parts where like the guy gets like the firecracker wrapped like sticky tape to his hand.
Oh.
I was like, geez, that's a bit much. But if there had been more things like that, as opposed to we're going to put this struggling porn actress trying to make it into horror movies underwater for 4 minutes, then I would have liked the movie a bit more. Instead, whole thing where it's like she didn't even get a breath, like it just made me angry, because I'm like, that wasn't even fair. But like, I didn't care enough about Sasha Grey to want her to live. Likewise, the ending just fucked it all up. It felt like they got rid of some characters a bit too quick.
Like, I felt a bit sorry for the old woman, because I was like, oh, she's gonna die anyway. But I'm like, oh, I feel bad though, because I wanted to stab her in the leg, and I'm looking at her, I'm like, Jesus, she's not gonna take much, she's gonna die.
Don't stab me.
Yeah.
I did think there was going to be some kind of twist with the old lady, because they also did this in Devil.
You're going to lose all your fancy foosball games, and you're going to fail your big exam, because school is
the devil. Everything is the devil to you, mama.
But like, the old lady was going to turn out to be like the mother, or like the wife of the party host or something. She's just as like a, what do you call it? Like a, not a
mediator.
Yeah, they did that with Devil, where they killed the old lady second in the movie, and then she's revealed to be the devil.
I think if they did it like room to room, like even if they did that barrel scene, but maybe had a pool scene and they all had to go out and then someone had to dunk their head in that, I think it just would have been...
Yeah, a few different set pieces could have livened it up a bit.
Yeah, because it's just sort of like, you kind of like, there's some of these movies where you just like know where it's going to go, and I'm like, it's going to be just this one shot, it's one room, like obviously the budget's quite low, but I'm sure like they could have, there's another room in that house, surely. They could have done something with them. I don't know. Here's what it is.
Line up for tonight's festivities. We're going to play a game called Cocaine or Dildo.
Thanks, BP and Coop, for joining me today. Listeners, in our next episode, we discuss Captivity, the 2007 hot trash, fucking stupid, goddamn awful excuse for a splatter horror.
All right, let's tell each other a secret about ourselves. I'm going to go first. I hate you.
And next month, we discuss all 5 Scream films. Plus, from June to July, we discuss all the Chucky films and the TV series in our Child's Play miniseries.
It's showtime!
Comment below if you'd like to see us take on a particular horror movie. or if you would like to join as a guest co-host. Feel free to chuck us a like, comment, tip, all that shit. Subscribe for more if you'd like to be the first to listen to our newest episodes. And if you hated our podcast...
I don't know, like, why you need us to like you so bad. Like, why you need my validation. Go brush your hair, bitch. Go brush your hair.
Bye for now. It's dark, but just... Okay.